Sup guys, Heeking here. Sorry for not being available for the past few days, weeks. I've been very, very ill, obviously. I mean, recovering, feeling a lot better now. I'm gonna start off this week with a trailer react or teaser reaction to Kingsman 2, The Golden Circle. So finally, we got a teaser release for this bad boy. Been waiting ages to see what this movie's gonna look like, so. Yeah. I really did like the first movie. Not the biggest fan, but definitely a good surprise of that year when it came out. So let's continue that journey. Hopefully the sequel will be better. The fact they got Matthew Vega back to, well, he decided to come back and direct the sequel is unheard of since he doesn't do sequels. So hopefully this won't be a Kick-Ass 2 kind of thing, and will be more of a Kick-Ass 1 kind of thing, if you know what I mean, yeah. So yeah, it should be, hopefully this should be good. So here we go, starting now.
Exit.
Exit.
I saw in you what someone once saw in me.
Flashbacks to the first film.
Something that can't be taught. The makings of a Kingsman. Being a Kingsman is more than the clothing we wear or the weapons we bear. It's about being willing to sacrifice for the greater good. I hope you're ready.
On an underwater
what comes next.
Minicab, okay. They blew up the mansion. Apocalypse would be proud. Mark Stone's back, also.
I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. For what is a man? What has he got?
Ooh.
If not himself.
Statesman. Is that Channing Tatum? Yeah. A robotic. What? Julia Moore, Mark Strong, Halle Berry, Jeff Bridges. And that was the Red Viper, wasn't it? Oh.
Oh my god. Harry?
So he did get shot in the eye. Interesting. I don't see his name up here, sadly. Elton John, but no Pedro Pascal. Oh, come on. Okay, so yeah, no, that was good. That was good for a teaser. That was definitely all right. Gives you an idea what to expect. Is the girl from the first movie in this or not? Roxy, was it? Like, I don't think I saw her in there. Unless that was, I mean, I don't know if that was a flashback from one. If that was part of the sequel, so they obviously had a new leader as well, so that replaced Michael Caine. But yeah, it looks cool. Like the action looks a bit more insane than the first one. Robotic arms and shit. Like what? There's that some next Metal Gear Solid Phantom Pain stuff going on there. Logan stuff and yeah, that's all it's about now. Like comic books, you know, your villains need robotic arms now. Like, no, it was kind of cool. Like with the whip punching out, it's kind of cool. Yeah, honestly, I don't know what to say except yeah. Colin Firth is obviously back. We knew he was gonna come back. The idea of how he was gonna come back was a bit like, how are they gonna do that? So yeah, he did get shot in the eye because I read a theory, and this was actually a very good theory actually because the way they filmed his death in the first movie. The way they did that, they kind of made it possible to actually explain how he would have survived. Because if you remember in the first movie, when he gets shot, right, the camera angle is from the side. It's not from the back. It's not from the front. It's from the side. So, and Samuel Jackson, when he ends up shooting him, right, he kind of looks away as he shoots. So a lot of our assumption was that perhaps the bullet might have just kind of like gone past and grazed him, hit the glasses maybe, he would have fallen down, and obviously they didn't check his body. Like, you know, Samuel Jackson's like, did I kill him? Like, and his henchwoman's like, yeah, you obviously, you know, shot him in the head. Obviously, they didn't shoot him in the head. They didn't even check if he was still breathing or dead or not. Like, they just sort of just walked away because of his disdain for blood and that. So, obviously, that's a nice way of explaining how he could have survived. He got shot in the eye, looks like it. So, maybe he had a bullet. Maybe he had a fake eye and it was a shield, perhaps. I don't know. But, yeah, the explanation for that and the reveal for that, how they're going to do that, like, is going to be very funny, I hope. Because the first movie was definitely very surprisingly, it was good. My biggest problem was sort of that some of the cheesy parts in the ending of the third act. I feel like that could have been better handled, but it was definitely a good surprising film. So, and that church scene, oh my god, that church scene. They need something like that to have in this movie. So, yeah, it looks cool. It looks cool and I'm excited. So many good films coming out this year, man, like, oh, yeah. But my most anticipated so far is Thor Ragnarok. I'm just going to say that now. Thor Ragnarok is my most anticipated film. It's a Star Wars Episode 8. Like, teaser didn't do anything for me, sadly. Surprisingly, I enjoyed the Transformers final, well, not the third trailer that came out. I really liked that. I wish I had done a reaction to that, but I was just like, oh, it's Transformers, it's not going to be that cool. But no, the trailer was really good. I love the trailer music for that, so that was that's probably my second favorite, actually. I know I shouldn't say that, but like, no, I generally like that for some reason. But yeah, hoping for a trailer for that, or final trailer for that. I'm hoping for something for Alien maybe, but that's coming out in 2 weeks or 2-3 weeks, so I don't think there's any point now to release a final trailer for that. Yeah, honestly, I don't know what more to say, guys, just, yeah, cool. And, yeah, thank you for the bless yous. You better have blessed me. Take care and bye, guys, and I shall see you when I shall see you. As always, like and subscribe. Take care and bye.